إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، last session, last week we started talking about الإسراء والمعراج. And just to refresh your memory, Al-Isra meaning traveling at night, Usriya. Wal-Mi'raj meaning ascending to the sky, Mi'raj. And we said that Al-Isra, the ayat and the mentioning in the Quran was the story or the incident, it was mentioned in Surat, who knows? Surat? Huh? سورة الإسراء. المعراج mentioned in سورة النجم. So الإسراء was mentioned in سورة الإسراء at the beginning of the سورة. And المعراج was mentioned in سورة النجم when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ascended. So there are actually two incidents, two things that happen at that story, at that miracle, we say. And last week, I spoke about some of the things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw when he was traveling to Bayt al-Maqdis, Masjid al-Aqsa. Yeah. So the Prophet he saw some things of the unseen, min al-ghayb. Allah showed him some things, and now we will continue what he saw and what happened. there is one seeing, وَكُشِفَ لَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ عَنْ آكِلِ الرِّبَى. We all know that riba, usury, interest, is a major sin. And we noticed from even last week when I mentioned some of the incidents that took place. Let me just turn this off. We noticed that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke or saw people of major sins, how they were tortured and how they will be tortured in the day of judgment. One of them is akilu riba. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw rajulan yasbahu fi nahrin min dam, a man swimming in a river of blood. وَيُلْقَمُ الْحِجَارَةِ, and he's eating stones. فَقَالَ صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet asked Jibreel, مَنْ هَذَا, who is this? فَقَالَ جِبْرِيلُ, هَذَا آكِلُ الرِّبَى, this is a man who eats interest, who uses interest money, usury, riba. ذكر ذلك الإمام أحمد في مسنده. And also the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw a group of people when he was going to Bayt al-Maqdis on the way. تقرض ألسنتهم وشفاههم بمقاريض من نار, clips of fire. Here their lips and their tongues are being clipped with it. كلما قرضت عادت كما كانت. They're clipped and then they are back to its normal يعني thing. They're not harmed again and they're clipped again. لا يفتر عنهم في ذلك شيء. فقال رسول الله, يا جبريل, من هؤلاء؟ أو جبريل, who are these people? فقال جبريل, خطباء من أمتك يأمرون الناس بالبر وينسون أنفسهم وهم يتلون الكتاب أفلا يعقلون. These are the preachers and the imams of your ummah, that they say things, they contradict themselves. يأمرون الناس بالبر, they tell people do good, and they themselves don't do it. نسأل الله العافية والسلامة. These are also people who are being punished in the day of judgment. Now, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached to Bayt al-Maqdis, when he reached there, some of the narrations say that the Prophet prayed with who? Not the Sahaba, the Prophets, sahih? Other narrations, Al-Hafidh ibn Kathir, في فتح الباري, he said that they prayed, according to the narrations, that he prayed before he ascended to the sky. But that's who, الفتح, Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, عفواً. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani said that في فتح الباري. He said he prayed with the prophets before he ascended to the sky. Ibn Kathir fi al-bidayah wal-nihayah said no. He prayed after he came back. So when he went to the sky, what happened, and we will talk about that, then when he came back, then he prayed with the prophets. And he said, this is وَهَذَا أَقْرَبُ لِلصَّوَابُ وَاللَّهُ تَعَالَىٰ أَعْلَمُ. This is, seems this is the correct narration. That he came back, then he prayed with the prophets. We'll get to that inshallah. Now there is one narration that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was thirsty when he reached to Bayt al-Maqdis. وَهَذَا رَوَى الْإِمَامُ مُسْلِمْ فِي صَحِيحِهِ وَالْإِمَامُ أَحْمَدْ فِي مُسْنَدِهِ. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثُمَّ دَخَلْتُ الْمَسْجِدِ مَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى فَصَلَّيْتُ فِيهِ رَكْعَتَيْنِ. And he prayed two rak'as. Then Jibreel came to him, alayhi salam, and he brought to him a bowl that has ina fihi khamr. Khamr, we know what khamr is. Fihi khamr, alcohol. Wa ina min laban. Laban means, huh? Milk. Exactly, not yogurt. Milk. Laban is milk. Wa ina'un fihi laban. فاخترت اللبن. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم chose لبن. فقال جبريل, جبريل said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, اخترت الفطرة. You chose a natural choice, a good choice. طيب, question. This khamr that was presented to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, was it from this dunya? No. It's from the akhirah, from the Jannah. Sahih? Is it haram for him, or was it haram for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to drink that? No. Because it is as if it is from the Jannah. It is not the ruling of the dunya. Why would Jibreel give him something that's haram? Sah? No. Things of the Jannah different from things of the dunya. It's not the filthy stuff that we see here. No, it's different. Yeah? Jannah things are different. Maybe they have the same names. Khamr, asal, misk, you know, honey, all that. But they're not actually the same. Because the Prophet told us. He said in Jannah, things there, he described it as مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى بَالِ أَحَدْ. يعني, the things in Jannah have the same names, but it's not what you see here, and it's not what you hear here, and it will not even come to your mind. يعني, don't try and be creative. Like, oh, I think it's like that, it smells. No, 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 you cannot. خلاص, it's something that out of the ordinary, out of the of your spectrum of the world. طيب. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم chose milk, لبن. طيب, صعود الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في المعارج إلى السماوات. Before we go and speak about the Mi'raj, the ascendance. Subhanallah, this story about Bayt al-Maqdis is a very important story.
It tells us that this location is a religious important location for the Muslimin.
I'll give you a small example, and Allah is greater than these examples. When you want to go see someone, a very important high person, CEO, president, whatever, before you meet him, don't they make you sit in a lounge? Small lounge, you drink something, you know, like hospitality. Sahih? And this place is important. Important people go to it. And it's a strategic place. Bayt al-Maqdis is the same thing. Al-Quds. Same, it is a strategic place. How Allah Azza wa Jal, before he came to the sky, يعني Allah cannot just take him from Mecca to ascend him to Sidrat al-Muntaha. Can. Sahih? Allah can take him there. No need for him to go to Bayt al-Maqdis. Such a long travel. But he didn't do that. Because he wants to tell us and tell the Ummah and tell the world that Bayt al-Maqdis is a very important place for the Muslimin. It is al-Qibla. Thalith al-Qibla. Thalith al-Qibla for the Muslimin. And so we have to religiously be attached to that place. Religiously be attached to that place. And inshallah, Allah will bring that yani location back to us, the Muslimin. But when we say religious, what does that mean? Meaning that you will not be able to solve the problem unreligiously, in a secular way. When you want to please Allah, we obey Him. Does it make sense if you want to please Allah, you disobey Him? Or you do things He doesn't like? How is that? Then Allah will leave you. Allah will not be pleased with you. Same thing with religious matters. You want to achieve a religious matter? You want to be successful in a religious matter? What do you have to do? Get close to Allah. Be religious. Today people don't do that. Today people, they think of things as secular. They keep it away from religion. They want to achieve something in their own logic and in their own might. When something bad happens in a location in the world, and you know what I mean, what do? They disobey Allah, and they use that to solve the problem. Protests are there. Other means that are haram are there. طيب how will Allah aid us? Allah will not aid us like this. I'll give you one example, small example, and reflect upon that. Ghazwat Uhud, Battle of Uhud. We'll talk about it inshallah. Everything was going great. Sahaba, did they have shirk? No. Sahaba, did they have bid'ah? No. Best of people, with the Prophet, best of leaders, best of men, powerful, iman full. They were fighting. Then, one mistake happened. The Prophet told the archers, don't come down and stay on top. What happened? They came down. We lost. Bas. They disobeyed Allah. They disobeyed the Messenger. They lost. Allah did not make tawfiq to them. And they were good in numbers and in might. Sah? يعني أسباب دنيوية was there. Materialistically, that they had weapons, they had people, they were there. But they lost. طيب غزوة بدر. Less people. Less weapons, less men, less horses, they won. Why? Because they were fully obedient to Allah. Fully reliant on Allah. Allah made them victorious. We have to reflect upon that. طيب today the Ummah, how much shirk do we have in it? Ummah, to get all in general. Ask them what is La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. They will don't know. Many Muslimin, they don't know. They say, no God but Allah. Wrong. Ask them about the Sunnah, they don't know. Fajr prayer, maybe one line. Protest, millions. But let's reflect upon that. Yeah, how will Allah aid us if we're like that? Huh? Today we are still debating bid'ah. We're still debating taraweeh bid'ah, not bid'ah. Yani, yeah, this khalas. You don't even know the sunnah. You don't even know the bid'ah. And you want to solve big global complex issues? You're not going to do that. Fix yourself first. Fix yourself. Allah will fix us all. Wallahu al-musta'an. صعود الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في المعارج إلى السماء. After the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed in بيت المقدس. جبريل عليه السلام took his hand and took him to the sky. إلى السماء الدنيا. The first sky. فجئت إلى السماء الدنيا. He reached to the gates. And the gatekeeper there, Jibreel told him, افتح, open. Open the gates. فقال من أنت? Who are you? أنا جبريل. I am Jibreel. And who is with you? Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقد أرسل إليه. He was called. فقال نعم. وقال مرحبا به. Welcome. فنعم المجيء جاء. يعني praising his welcome and praising his attendance or him coming there, and it was opened. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is narrating this, what happened. علونا إلى السماء الدنيا فإذا رجل قاعد عن يمينه أسودة وعن يساره أسودة. He saw a man. This is now he entered السماء الدنيا. Now the first level of sama, of the sky, of the heavens. Heavens means sky, يعني up. Yeah. He saw a man. On his right, وسادة, أسودة. أسودة means بوزن أزمنة وهي أشخاص. أسودة means people. This is what, who said this? الحافظ ابن حجر. On his right people, on his left people. And he said, when he looks to the right, he smiles. When he looks to the left, he cries. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من هذا? Who is this man? فقال جبريل هذا أبوك آدم. This is your father آدم عليه السلام. فسلم عليه فسلمت عليه. Then he did salam to him. فرد السلام. And he returned the salam. Then Adam told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم مرحبا بالابن الصالح والنبي الصالح. Welcome, good, oh good son and good messenger. ثم قال جبريل وهذه الأسودة عن يمينه وعن شماله نسم بنيه. These right people and left people it's like a metaphor of the people of Jannah and people of the hellfire. And these are his sons, as if. And when he looks at the right, he smiles. And when he looks at the left, he cries. Now, in one hadith, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was on the first level of the heavens, he said something. He told us of another scenery that he saw. قال لما دخلت السماء الدنيا رأيت رجالا لهم مشافر كمشافر الإبل. When I entered the first heaven, I saw men with lips of camels, big forward lips. Looks weird if you try to imagine it. في أيديهم قطع من نار كالأفهار. In their hands, big rocks of fire. يقذفونها في أفواههم. They're swallowing it. فتخرج من أدبارهم. They're coming. It comes out from their behinds. The Prophet said, "Who are these people? They're in torture. This is torture for them." The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Jibreel, "Who are these people?" فقال هؤلاء أكلت أموال اليتامى ظلما.
they use and they take the money of the orphans unjustly, unfairly, stealing. You know, orphans are poor and they're يعني powerless, helpless. And it's Allah al-afiyah. People sometimes take their money unjustly. Allah will punish them like this in the akhirah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also said, I saw women معلقات بثديهن. They were hanging from their chests. فقلت من هؤلاء يا جبريل? Who are these women that are hanging from their chests? You know, like a cow in the butcher shop, how they're hanging? Same thing. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال هؤلاء اللاتي أدخلنا على الرجال من ليس من أولادهن. They are the women who enter or who are intimate with other than their husbands. زنا يعني. Women of zina. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, and he saw men بين أيديهم لحم سمين طيب. Men who have meat that is juicy and tasty on their right. وَإِلَى جَنْبِهِ لَحْمٌ غَثٌ مُنْتٍ. And in their left, meat that is expired and rotten, stinky meat. فَيَأْكُلُونَ الْغَثْ. They are eating the stinky, rotten meat. وَيَتْرُكُونَ السَّمِينَ الطَّيِّبَ. And they leave what is good and juicy and tasty and fresh. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من هؤلاء يا جبريل? Who are these people O Jibreel? He said هؤلاء الذين يتركون ما أحل الله لهم من النساء ويذهبون إلى ما حرم الله عليهن منهن عليهم منهن. These are the people who leave being intimate with their lawful wives and go to haram relationships and having zina with women that are unlawful to them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma thabbitna. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to the second sky now. ثُمَّ عُرِجَ بِنَا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الثَّانِيَةِ فَاسْتَفْتَحَ جِبْرِيلَ. Jibreel told them to open the gates. فَقَالَ who is this? They said, who are you? Said Jibreel. وَمَنْ مَعَكَ and who is with you? Who is with me? Muhammad. Then they said, welcome. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَفُتِحَ لَنَا فَإِذَا أَنَا بِبْنِ الْخَالَةِ يَحْيَ بْنُ زَكَرِيَّا وَعِيسَ بْنُ مَرْيَمِ. يَحْيَ ابْنُ زَكَرِيَّا. He saw the messenger. يَحْيَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ وَعِيسَ بْنُ مَرْيَمِ. Jesus عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. فَقَالَ جِبْرِيلُ. Now Jibreel is presenting them, introducing them to each other. He said, this is Yahya and this is Isa. فَسَلَّمَ عَلَيْهِمَا. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did salam and they returned the salam to him and they said, مَرْحَبًا بِالْأَخِ الصَّالِحِ وَالنَّبِيِّ الصَّالِحِ وَدَعُوا لَهْ بِخَيْرِ. Yahya and Isa said, مَرْحَبًا, welcome, O good brother and good messenger. And they did dua for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is evidence, subhanAllah, that we should do dua to one another. Brothers and sisters, we have to do dua to another. No need for someone to ask you to do dua for your brothers. And the best of dua for your brothers is an dhahri ghaib. That without even asking you, you do dua without anyone seeing you. Or not doing dua in front of your brother to him. When you are doing salah or something, do dua for your brothers. Your friends, your brothers, your sisters, or whoever. Muslimin. Tayyib. Then they went to the third sky. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he reached, he saw Yusuf alayhi salam. And he also again said, salam alayhi, he did salam to him and Yusuf returned the salam and he said, welcome, O good brother and good messenger. And he also did dua for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِذَا هُوَ قَدْ أُعْطِيَ شَطْرَ الْحُسْنِ. The Prophet said, when he saw Yusuf, he saw he was so handsome that half of the beauty of the world was given to him. Shatr. Shatr means half. Al-Husni means beauty. So Yusuf was very, very handsome. And of course, in Surah Yusuf, we
Allah mentioned some of the things in that matter. And by the way, بالمناسبه, Surah Yusuf was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after the year of sorrow, all of it. And it is the only surah that was fully about one story, and it's the only story of Yusuf. And subhanAllah, we contemplate or reflect upon this, is that it's like Allah Azza wa Jal is supporting or aiding or making it easy on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, telling him this story specifically, because his family betrayed him and he was kicked out of his land, and you know, many things happened to him. It's like Allah Azza wa Jal is telling him, making it easy on him, how the hardships that followed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam during the year of sorrow and what happened. طيب. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to the fourth sky, and there he saw Idris alayhi salam. Fasallama alayhi, did salam to him, and he returned the salam, and he also said marhaban bil akhi salih wa an-nabiy salih wa da'a bi khair wa da'a lahu bi khair. He said salam to him, he said welcome, oh good brother and good messenger. Thumma qala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an Idris, and he said about Idris, as Allah mentioned in the Quran, wa rafa'nahu makanan 'aliyya, that Allah elevated him a high status. طيب. وثم, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to the fifth sky, and there he saw Harun. You know Harun? Yeah, Moses's brother. And some of the ulama, they said this was the greatest wasta, that Harun was a prophet. How? Musa, when Musa was appointed as a messenger to go to Pharaoh, then Moses or Musa alayhi salam asked Allah, اجعل لي وزيرا. Or what was the ayah in Surah Taha? I forgot. صح, وزيرا من أهلي. اجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي أشدد به. I forgot the ayah, subhanAllah. Anyways, so the point is that Moses asked Allah Azza wa Jal to appoint his brother as a prophet. Wasta, but this is a good wasta, not bad wasta. So Allah Azza wa Jal returned or answered his request. So he saw him there, and again, of course, he did salam to him. And he left, he went. وَقَدْ أُرْسِلَ مَرْحَبًا بِالْأَخِ الصَّالِحِ وَالنَّبِيِّ الصَّالِحِ. He welcomed him and he did dua for him. Also, وَقَالَ فَفُتِحَ لَنَا, where is it? أُرْسِلَ عَلَيْهِ مَرْحَبًا. طيب, صعود السادسة. This is the sixth. No, first we said, yeah, Harun is the fifth. Then he went to the sixth heaven, sixth level, which is where Musa is. Moses was there. So he saw Moses, and the same thing, he did salam to him, and he said marhaban bil akhi salih wa an-nabiy salih, welcome, oh good brother and good messenger. Then the Prophet here sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described Musa. He said marartu laylata usriya bi ala Musa ibn Imran, and he said kana rajulan adama tiwal ja'd. I don't know about the grammar here, but anyways, that's what's written. Tiwalin ja'din. He was a man, dark skin. Tiwal, tall. Ja'd. Some of the mufassirin said ja'd, meaning big body, bulky. And other mufassirin said, no, his hair is curly. Ja'd means curly hair. Some of them, they said both. He was big, bulky, and he had curly hair, and he was dark. Dark-skinned guy. كَأَنَّهُ مِنْ رِجَالِ شَنُوَى. There was a tribe back in the Arabian Peninsula. They called them Shanua. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام described him as them. He looked like the people of Shanua. How are they? I don't know. It wasn't mentioned here. So I don't know how the Shanua people look. Maybe you can research about that.
قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فَلَمَّا تَجَاوَزْتُهُ بَكَى. When the Prophet passed, he said salam to Musa, and he passed. Moses cried.
فقيل ما يبكيك what why are you crying oh Musa قال أبكي I cry because a young man غلاما بعث بعدي يدخل الجنة من أمته أكثر ممن يدخلها من أمتي I cry because a young man غلام was sent after me and his ummah this is good news for us his ummah are going to be more than my ummah entering Jannah أسأل الله عز وجل أن نكون من أهل الجنة say آمين طيب here there's a point to mention when he said غلام does he disrespect يعني he meant disrespect no he just meant that he's a young man and is he complaining on the qadr of Allah no this is different if you as a man as a Muslim feel regret or cry on something that is khair that missed you that's fine يعني one guy missed salat al-duha or obligatory prayer he slept salat al-fajr and he woke up and he cried or he was sad that's fine no one can come and tell you why are you crying on qada Allah wa qadari no when is it impermissible when you cry on qada Allah not about you doing khair but about things that Allah has decreed upon you death sickness accidents, bad things happen at work, whatever, general things. If these things take place in your life, don't say, oh, what if, and I could have avoided it, and all. This is wrong. This is complaining about the decree of Allah, qada of Allah. Yeah? It's different. طيب. Then last level of the sky, how much time did we take? Okay, we have to finish soon, 10 minutes. Last sky was السماء السابعة, the seventh sky. Who did he see? Imam al-Rusul. طبعا بعد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. He saw Ibrahim عليه السلام. فإذا أنا بإبراهيم مسندا ظهره إلى البيت المعمور. Ibrahim was there leaning on البيت المعمور. البيت المعمور the علماء they said according to the hadiths and the narrations it is the المعمور البيت المعمور the established house where is it it's right directly on top of الكعبة every day 70,000 angels enter كل يوم يدخله 70,000 ملك They enter, they worship Allah the way they worship Allah and they come out, they don't go back to it again. And every day another new 70,000 enter. Subhanallah. Shows you how much is the quantity of the angels until the day of judgment. Huge amount of angels. فهي saw Ibrahim leaning towards al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. So Jibreel said, this is your father Ibrahim. So he did salam to him. And again, here he said, مرحباً بالابن الصالح. Welcome, O good son and good messenger. In another narration, في رواه الإمام الترمذي في جامعه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لقيت إبراهيم ليلة أسري بي فقال يا محمد. Ibrahim told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, O Muhammad, أقرئ أمتك السلام. Say salam to your ummah. Ibrahim is telling us his salam, sending us his salam. وَأَخْبِرْهُمْ أَنَّ الْجَنَّةَ طَيِّبَةُ التُّرْبَةِ And tell them about Jannah. Tell them that Jannah, that the soil of the Jannah is beautiful, طيب, good. عَذْبَةُ الْمَاء, pure water. وَأَنَّهَا قِيعَانٌ قِيعَانٌ جَمْعُ قَاعُ وَهُوَ الْمَكَانُ الْمُسْتَوِي فِي وَطْأَةٍ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ لَا يَعْلُوهُ الْمَاءَ السَّمَاءَ فَيُمْسِكُهُ يعني it is straight, not up, down, up, down. It's straight and it's something that to tell us the beauty of Jannah. Of course, we can maybe kind of be creative or imagine, but you will not imagine clearly what it is. وأن غرس غراسها غراسة means its pegs or things that are embedded in it, in its soil. سبحان الله, saying سبحان الله والحمد لله, and saying والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. These are the remembrance, dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. And see, no doubt this is from Jannah. When you say it, it's a connection of you to Jannah. So Allah Azza wa Jal نكون منهم. طيب, some of the ulama, they said, يعني we know that there are more prophets than this. Why did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam see these prophets in these levels of the skies? Why not others? قالوا فأما آدم, he saw Adam عليه السلام telling him or relating to him the hijra of Mecca to Medina. Because Adam was kicked out. صحيح? He was kicked out from? Yeah, he was sent down from paradise to dunya. So it is the same thing. It's as if Allah Azza wa Jalla is relating this to the hijra of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Mecca to Medina. Then he saw عيسى أن يحيى من أول الهجرة من عادوه. And it is also related to the Jews, اليهود, how they attacked عيسى ويحيى. صحيح? At the time when the revelation of عيسى عليه السلام ويحيى ابن زكريا عليه السلام, who were attacking these two prophets? The Jews, اليهود. It's a relation, it's a connection of this and how the Jews are going to attack the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how they are going to cause enmity and hate and aggression towards him and how they will betray. Some of the stories, inshallah, we'll come to it in the seerah, how they betrayed the pact. And this is their hal in every year, every century. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. وبي يوسف. Yusuf alayhi salam also. Why did Allah make the Prophet meet Yusuf? Because Yusuf also, his family and his tribe's people turned against him. Didn't his brother try to kill him? Same thing with Abu Lahab and the tribe's people of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how they tried to kill him and attack him. People, your own family, your own people, your own kind going against you. And then Yusuf, what did he do when he was in power and he was going to take a decision? Should he take vengeance or no? ماذا قال يوسف؟ قال لا تثريب عليكم اليوم. It's beautiful. لا تثريب عليكم اليوم. That means I forgive you and I'm not gonna remind you of that forgiveness. خلاص, it's gone. Forget about it as if nothing happened. Nothing happened. Sometimes when we forgive people, we don't really forgive them. We forgive them but we keep rubbing it in. I forgave you. I forgave you. It's not true forgiveness. Yeah. When you forgive someone, يعني sincerely forgive him for the sake of Allah. خلاص, as if nothing happened. Don't keep anything in your heart. And some people say, I'll forgive you. But in other situations, he attacks him, takes vengeance from him. Yeah? And this is also not forgiveness, true forgiveness. SubhanAllah, this tells us something, my brothers. Allah Azza wa Jal will bring lessons and experiences in your life. Incidents happen in your life. You as a Muslim have to be wary, yani be mindful and be observant of things that happen in your life and things that happen in the world. Take lessons from them and benefit from them. Just as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did this miraculous thing that happened to him, the Isra wal Mi'raj. He took lessons from these things and he applied them and he taught us what to do, what to avoid, how to do things. We have to be the same. Some people, many experiences happen in his life. He doesn't take any fa'ida, any benefit from it. هذا ليس حال المسلم. This is not the situation of a Muslim. It's like, you know, you go to school and you learn for 10 years and you go to college and you learn, you become like a doctor or engineer, and it's as if you learn nothing. You're a lousy person. Your job, you're very bad. And we see people, subhanAllah, sometimes they go, for example, go to training courses. They train about a certain thing and skills in life. They come with a certificate. Ah, I finished. But they don't apply anything. So what did you learn from your experience, your training? What did you learn from it? Nothing. Same thing with life and deen. You have to extract the benefits and the hikmah, the wisdom about things that happen in your life. Or else, what is the purpose of you seeing these things and experiencing these things in life? طيب. I think we should finish today. Stop. It's too much because then later we also have a lot of things. Wallahi, يعني, in sealed nectar, he didn't talk much about Isra' al-Mi'raj. But I think Wallahi, Isra' al-Mi'raj is a very important incident, especially nowadays. So we should talk about it and we should take extract as many benefits as possible from it. It is one of the greatest things that happened at the time of the revelation of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We shouldn't like just pass on through it like that. Wallahu al-musta'an. So we'll have three parts of Isra al-Mi'raj. This is the second part. Inshallah, next week we'll continue with Isra al-Mi'raj. Inshallah. طيب جزاكم الله خير. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Anybody has any questions with regards to the درس? No questions, inshallah. طيب بارك الله فيكم وجزاكم الله خيرا. آخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.